they come back the next day and you're expecting, thank you for doing that for me. But they didn't notice it needed to be done, so they don't notice that you did it. And then you look at them and you go, I didn't even get a thank you. I am definitely not appreciated around here.
You know, you're dead on. You're dead on. I'm getting a message from my husband that says you're dead on, yep. And I just... That's amazing.
This is something we have to listen to in the car on the to and from the station when we carpool. You know, she's in the back seat going on and on. She's going on and on about how she's not appreciated. I don't know how many times do I have to say it.
Now the solution is also in the name, which is what I think is the coolest part. So in your name, if you would say instead of doing it for them what they didn't see needed to be done. The next day you wait, you hold off as hard as it is, and you hold off and you say, I noticed you didn't do such and such. Would you like some help? Now, whether they say yes or no, you're willing to pitch in and do it. But now they'll notice that you did it, and that's when you'll get your thank you.
Wow. That's true. It's true.
You're getting creepy. You're getting chills is what you're doing.
Yes, I have two family members listening, my daughter and my husband, and they're like, oh my gosh, they're just like, they can't, they're creepy.
Now that's anybody with the first letter of A. Now we're going to go to your second letter. The second letter is an I. It's in the middle letter position. It's not the first, it's not the first vowel, and it's not the last letter. So it's what I call the middle letter position. Anybody that has an I in the middle letter position in their name, it says, I'm independent. Do not even think about trying to tell me what to do. You can ask, but do not tell, because I'm independent. I don't like to be told.
Yes, definitely. I'm one of the most independent people I know. Nick's pointing at me. And
oh yeah, I'm just nodding my head. I'm letting you talk, Sharon. I'm not trying to interrupt.
Wow.
I'm just bobbing my head back and forth.
Then I'm going with the M. Okay, now I'm just giving some of the traits because
right.
Every letter has a lot of traits.
Sure.
I'm giving you the M. The M says I take to the extreme anything that's right next to me. You have independence next to you, so you got to take that, you know, push it. It's a bit extreme, okay?
I'm a bit of an extreme person, yes, yes, wow.
Okay, and it means what you like, and what you don't like, and you don't want to do what you don't like to do.
Wow.
You're going to find somebody else to do it.
Yes.
Okay, then I come to the EE. Now, this is interesting, because look at all the names out there that end in an E. It means these people are overly generous with their time. Which means somebody comes up to you and says, Amy, can you help me get such and such done? You go, sure. So you go and help them get their stuff done. At the end of the day, they get to go home, their stuff's done. But you still have to stay there because your stuff isn't done.
Oh, my. And that's exactly how it is. That's how it is at my day job. Oh, my gosh. And well, it's like that at home, too.
Whose name ends in an E has that as a learning thing. And so, remember, the answer is always in the name.
Yeah.
So instead you say, I would love to help you, because in truth you would. And you say, let me finish mine first, and then I'll come help you. That means the other person can say, can I help you with yours and get it done faster so you can come help me? Or you're going to get yours done first, and if somebody has to say, wait, it's them and not you.
I'll have to remember that. Thank you.
Now, the double E. There's a few names out there, like Kathleen also has it, that have two E's in a row. When two E's are sitting next to each other, it means I'm almost empathic. It's almost as if I can feel how other people are responding without them having to say anything.
I have goosebumps. I'm very sensitive to other people. I have goosebumps. I'm very empathic. Wow.
And that's represented by the double E in your name. And anybody who has that double E has that same quality.
Wow.
So I'm not making stuff up.
No,
I
believe you.
I literally digest the name apart.
No, let me tell you, I'm big into... I kind of classify this into, I don't know, like the Star Children and, what's the name? There's Star Children and there's Indigo Children and things like that. And I'm fascinated by that. And I believe in all of that. So I'm just amazed. I'm blown away because you are dead on with my, which is my first name. Wow.
Right. And then when I look at your middle name, the middle name represents who we become under extreme stress. If we're in a very stressful situation, you know, people morph. And you think,
oh, yeah.
Okay, hello, who are you? You know, it's because they're highly stressed. Now, if somebody doesn't have a middle name, whoever they are, they're the same under stress. But all of us that have middle names, that's who we become under stress. And your middle name says, I become the warrior, I become the person in charge. I become compassionate. But by golly, I'm going to tell you how we're all going to get through this, and y'all better listen and get going.
Wow.
She's an ass kisser. No, kicker. Pardon me.
Yes.
Not kisser. Ass kicker. What I meant to say. Sorry.
I am
aware. I don't mean to be vulgar. I apologize. You're an educated woman, and I know you're, the show is somewhat beneath you, but we do appreciate your appearance. So.
I think
you know,
Go ahead. Continue, please. I'm sorry to interrupt.
I'm just amazing.
But that says who we are under stress. Now, when you got your latest last name.
Which is okay. Stuyvesant.
Yes. Thank you. I didn't want to slaughter it.
That's okay. I'm used to it.
When you got your latest last name, you married into a family, and people in that family have learned that when they want something badly, they are the most stubborn people out there.
Oh, my God.
You cannot move them,
no.
change them, have them adapt or be flexible
no.
once they have made up their mind. It's
wow.
like they've made up their mind. They are a brick wall. So you have to nicely say, is this stubbornness working on your benefit or not? And you have to get them thinking about it. And you've got to give them choices. Which would you rather have, this or that? You go back as if they're almost 2 years old and you only gave two options. Did you want this or did you want that? Because they're not going to move otherwise.
Wow. That's,
you know?
I just can't, you just keep hitting the nail on the head.
Okay, and what we'll do is we'll decipher your husband's name.
Yes.
And then we have some more questions.
Yes, so his name is Michael Allen Stuyvesant.
Okay. Michael loves to go forward and be known to be helpful. He loves to be helpful. He wants to be known as one of the most helpful people on the planet. And yet, when he helps, he wants to do it his way. So if you want his help loading the dishes a certain way, and he wants to load it a different way, if you want his help, he's going to load it the way he wants it.
Right. Wow.
Okay?
But see, now you're describing my son and my husband, because my son and husband have the same first and last name. So
well,
it's a double.
Same gene pool.
Yes.
Well, what happens in a first name that I think is really interesting is that the first name is the essence of who we are. But it's like we were given ingredients. Suppose in our first name we have the letters that, I'm going to change it to food so it's easy to understand. Suppose we have the letters that represent eggs and butter and cheese and some vegetables. Okay, that's my first name. Now, the last name tells me what am I going to do with that? What am I going to make out of those ingredients? I could make scrambled eggs. I could make egg tacos. I could make a quiche. You know, what am I going to make? I could make an omelet. And it says, here's your ingredients, and your last name says, what am I going to do with them? Because your last name represents your environment and what you're being taught.
Wow.
And that's why you'll find similarities with people with the same names. It's like they've got the same ingredients, but they may have made a different dish out of it.
Right. That's definitely. I mean, I can definitely see the difference in my husband and son's personality, even though they do have the same name. But there's a lot of common traits there as well.
Mm-hmm. So you see the common, the what they start with, and then what they do with it is up to their own free will.
And they are extremely stubborn men. I got to tell you, that got the same, you know, that last name, that stubborn.
Yes, it is. And I have mnemonic devices how to remember all of it.
I know.
So anybody that's got an ST in their name, like a Stephen or a Stephanie or your last name.
Right.
Anybody that has the ST in my mind says stubborn.
Stubborn.
And then
makes
every
sense.
Letter or combination has a challenge and a gift. So when the challenge is stubborn, the gift is persistence. They can take that stubbornness and they will persist against all odds to finish what they want to finish once they've
started. Yes, they do. Yes, they do. I'm just blown away. I'm just shaking my head. I have goosebumps. I just can't. I'm so glad we're getting. I'm glad you called in, Sharon. This is fascinating.
Well, there are many more questions we need to ask.
Yes.
One or two more names that we'll throw out there to you. But first, let's just again remind everybody who you are.
Yes.
Sharon Lynn Wyeth.
From California.
Are we pronouncing it Sharon? Is that how you.
Yes, it's like my Sharon.
Sharona.
Without the A.
Okay.
Yes, without the A.
Okay. Sharon Lynn Wyeth. The name of the book is Know the Name, Know the Person, Decoding Letters to Reveal Secrets Hidden in Names.
Now,
and
I'd like to add she also offers a 15-hour course.
No, I was going to get to that, but I want to. And the website, what is the name of your website, please?
Well, I have a gift for your listeners. If they go to bestnamemeanings.com or the first half of the book title, knowthename.com, okay, Know the Name is about the book, but Best Name Meanings plays with names a lot. Either one, and they sign up to start learning this, and it's free. The first week, they get something every day, and there's a lot there. Pick and choose. You get the first chapter of the book free. You get information on dating, what you're going to look for free. The first week, you're kind of overwhelmed. And after that, they become real short, real cute. Once a week, let's learn this. And it's absolutely free to your listeners that they sign up.
Fantastic.
I signed up already, so I've already gotten my first.
Fantastic. Just go ahead and repeat the name of the websites again.
KnowTheName.com. And bestnamemeanings.com. And then if you want the real depth of everything, of course, there's the Amazon bestseller, Know the Name, Know the Person.
Okay. Now, forgive me because I still listen to cassettes in my car, and I'm talking from a soundboard that Wolfman Jack used to play records on. Is this book Kindled? Is that what they call it, where you can download it?
Not yet.
Okay.
I'm working on that.
Okay. So they're actually going to get the paperback or the hardcover book.
Mm-hmm.
Which is what I like. Thank you very much. Books that don't run on batteries. But, you know, that's me. I'm in my 40s, but people think I'm in my 60s, as you well know. So that's it. So we would encourage our listeners to go to the sites and sign up and take advantage of this. We'll throw a couple of names at you. These are the names of some of our listeners.
Okay.
And when they found out that you were going to be on, they texted and messaged and they did everything else but call. And said, "Oh, okay, I got to know about my name." First one would be Eric, E-R-I-C, and last name Tulpo, T-U-L-P-P-O. So,
okay.
First thing, doesn't that just immediately the image in your mind? Doesn't that scream gay bodybuilder? Isn't that the first thing when you decipher that name, gay bodybuilder?
I have to laugh. Because when you have a C at the end of your name, it says that you have a femininity about you or a softness about you. And so many people who have a C at the end of their name, if they're not gay, many of them are, but if they're not, they have an effeminate side to them. Okay, but that's where I'm getting that from. But the E-R... The ER is one of the combinations that I just laugh when I see it because it means they love physical touch. And that's about as far as I want to go with that.
Yeah, we are on AM radio, so we got to watch what we say. So, yeah.
Okay. So, it's at the beginning of the name. So it means it's one of the most important things out there. Okay? But anywhere there's an ER. Now, parents, if you're looking at your child's name and you've got an ER in there, please teach your child about the birds and the bees young, because they're going to teach themselves otherwise. So do you want them learning on their own, or do you want some instruction in there?
Wow.
Anyway, with his name, I would say that he likes the truth. He's a warrior for the truth. He doesn't like to give somebody else a second chance if they tell him something that's not true. He doesn't like it. It's like off with their head. They weren't honest with me. He's highly independent. He's a warrior. He's got this rebellious streak in him. Oh, my gosh. Tell him no, and he says, oh, yeah, watch me. I'm going to do it anyway, just because you told me no. In his name, it says, I want to be known for something. I want to leave a legacy when I'm gone. And that's really important to him in his name. And what I love about his name is he must be so incredibly fun to be around, because so many of his letters say, I'm playful, I have a sense of humor, I'm fun, I'm the Pied Piper, everybody wants to be with me, I'm charismatic.
Yeah, yeah, he jokes around with us all.